हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आपां हुण पार्ट टू लर्नर सेंटर डिजाइनस दे बारे विस्तार विच पढ़ांगे। इस तो पहला आपां डिजाइन की हुंदा, करिकुलम डिजाइनस तीन तरह दे है, सब्जेक्ट सेंटर डिजाइनस, लर्नर सेंटर डिजाइनस एंड प्रॉब्लम सेंटर डिजाइनस, इन्हीं गल्लां कर चुके हैं। वी हैव ऑल्सो टॉक्ड अबाउट द सोर्सेज, वी हैव ऑल्सो टॉक्ड अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ करिकुलम। नाउ वी आर मूविंग टूवर्ड्स द सेकेंड पार्ट, दैट इज लर्नर सेंटर डिजाइनस। Learner-centered designs are of three types: child-centered designs, experience-centered designs, and humanistic designs. When we talk about child-centered design, this design was developed by John Dewey, Rousseau, Pestalozzi, Froebel. Means it is based on their philosophy of pragmatism. So they always believed that learning is always possible when the child is involved in some doing. So this curriculum design is specifically anchored around the needs and interest of the child, in which the learner is actively involved. He or she creates his or her own knowledge and constructs the meaning of knowledge by interacting with the environment. In this kind of design, the teacher, the student and the environment, tinno aapas vich ikatthe interact karde hai aur tinno milke एक्टिविटीज लेसन्स प्लान करते हैं, कंटेंट सिलेक्ट करते हैं, तीनों मिलके एक्टिविटीज करते हैं, एंड दैट वे द चिल्ड्रन लर्न फ्रॉम दैट इंटरेक्शन। सो दिस काइंड ऑफ डिज़ाइन, चाइल्ड सेंटर्ड डिज़ाइंस आर मोस्टली यू विल बी फाइंडिंग इट इन प्री प्राइमरी एंड प्राइमरी क्लासेस, एंड मोस्टली फॉर साइंस लर्निंग्स दिस काइंड ऑफ डिज़ाइंस आर वेरी यूजफुल। Then we move to the next design, that is experience-centered design. Experience-centered design is very close to child-centered design. It is also based on interest and needs of the learner, and it is also based on the assumption that children learn when they experience. When more and more senses are involved, the children learn out of those out of that activity more. Everything has to be done on the spot. Like if child is interested in a particular activity, there is a list of activities, children can choose those activities and they can get experience and they can learn. So this kind of designs are being followed in the schools, which are very open, flexible, and they have a different kind of evaluation system. They don't have the written kind of evaluation system, or they always judge the child, or they see how much the skills have been developed. So this kind of designs are used in vocational courses specifically. Then we move to the humanistic designs. The humanistic designs are influenced by the personalities like Abraham Maslow and Carl Rogers. They are of the belief that developing the human content in a human being is more important. So what do you mean by developing this human being? Human means the self. What is this self? Made up of cognitive, affective and cognitive domains, psychomotor domains, because all these three domains are interconnected. We have so many times discussed about all these domains and how they are interconnected in already in the different classrooms. So this kind of design stresses that all these three domains could be integrated, and the human being has to be developed through education. So the thinkings, feelings, everything has to be developed. So in this kind of children's humanistic designs, the persons who study this kind of designs, in under these kind of designs, they got a very good self-esteem. They emerge to be very empowered individual. This is the assumption of this design. Then we come to the third kind of designs. We did child-centered designs. There are three types. Now we are coming to the problem-centered designs. Problem-centered designs are of two types: life situation designs and code designs. Life situation designs, jis tarah ki isna de naam to hi pata hai, life situations nu particularly leke koi curriculum banaya janda hai. Suppose now we are facing this coronavirus situation, the whole world is facing this kind of situation, and this life situation compels us to create a design so that we can develop those kind of people who can work in this kind of environment for the coming 1 year, 2 year. Maybe this will emerge again and again, these kind of viruses. So how we will function? So the life situations which are crucial to the society and they are necessary for the successful functioning of the society, these curriculums make sense when they are particularly focused, they have a direct relevance to the study, when they are designed around a particular life situation. It may be a social life situation, it may be a it may be directly related to a mini society or to a larger society or to a global society. So in this kind of designs, all the subjects are integrated and children already learn by experiencing, by applying. These are naturally child-centered, but determining the sequence and the scope and the area is very difficult in these kind of designs. Then we come to the last part of this chapter, that is core design. Problem-centered designs, aggo do tarah de hai, life situation designs and core designs. Now we are on the core designs. So the core designs are the are focused on the common needs and problems and concern of the learner as well as of the society. Fons and Bossing have developed this kind of design, or they have supported this kind of design, and they said that initially the problems are being chosen. In the earlier chapter we did that analysis of society needs and the student needs. In this design, the curriculum developer will first choose the problem. It may be a teacher, student, curriculum developer. They will together analyze a problem. Then a group agreement is made. They will list out the important problems which are related to the day-to-day common needs, problems and concerns. And then these problems are clearly stated, defined, and then the work has been started. And then the persons work on it, research on it, they list out the resources, they analyze the situations, they take the data, they interpret it, and then they find out the conclusions, and then they make the reports, they present the reports, and they suggest the new avenues for exploration for further study. It is just like your dissertation, you're doing a mini research problem. So in core design, totally for every area, students are working on problems and they are learning. They are not learning separately all the subjects. They are learning all the subjects in an integrated form in these kind of core designs, which are basically research-based design. So it unifies the content and provides the relevant subject matter. It encourages active processing and fosters democratic process in the classroom. But it requires very exceptional teachers to follow these designs and to run these designs. Thank you so much. Stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. See you in the next lecture. Thank you.